Computer generated chess problem 02367 by Chessthetica. So white has two rooks and a bishop against black's two queens and a pawn. So black is ahead in material. But black's queen on e5 is in a position to be captured by the bishop. Incidentally, that queen also threatens the rook on d6. So perhaps the obvious thing to do here would be bishop captures e5. But if white does this, instead of recapturing with the other queen, black would just play c3 check, perhaps rook to e2 intervening, c2, bishop to f4, guarding the pawn promotion square. Black promotes anyway to queen with check, white captures, the king captures, and we basically have a drawn position, queen versus two rooks. And of course, if white were to try, say, rook on the d-file to d2, defending the bishop on b2 and also moving that rook out of harm's way, this would be a mistake because c3 discovered check, rook on the d-file to e2 intervening and saving the rook at least, queen to d3, the rook is pinned, so the queen on e5 is safe. White might try desperately bishop captures pawn. Queen on the e-file captures the bishop, king to g1, two queens versus two rooks doesn't look good for white, queen to c1 check, king to h2, queen to h6 check, king to g1, queen to d1 check, and if the rook intervenes, queen captures rook for mate, and if king to f2, queen to f4 mates. So rook d2 is also a mistake here. Let's look at what the best way to proceed in this position actually is. The answer is rook to d1, check. Now, obviously the king can't capture the bishop because it's defended by the other rook. So king to a2 is the only move. And here, white plays bishop to d4, discovered check. One step short of capturing the queen on e5. Now, why not bishop captures queen? Well, as you can see from the engine analysis, then king to a3, the mate stretches on longer than it needs to be. Bishop to d6, queen to b4, bishop captures b4, king captures b4, and this takes longer. So, one step short of capturing the queen, but creating a discovered check on the king nonetheless. And now here, if king to a3, rook to a1 check, and then if king to b3, or king to b4, rook to b2 mate. Now you can see why the bishop didn't go all the way and capture the other queen. It would leave the c5 square unguarded. So black can buy a little bit of time by sacrificing that queen anyway with a cross check. Rook captures queen, and we are in the same position that we were before. Now here, if queen to b2, another intervention, well then, rook captures b2, and king to a3, it's rook to a1, and as before, king to b4, or king to b3, it's rook to b2 with mate. And if king to b3 directly, well then, rook to b2 check, and the king is forced onto the a-file this time. If king to a3, rook to a1 mate, and king to a4, rook to a1 mates as well. So from the original position, white's position, which seems uncertain or even losing, is actually a forced mate. And only one exists, a mate in 5. The other moves do indeed result in white being checkmated, or at best a draw, as you can see from the analysis. Until the next one, thanks for watching.